Good afternoon, folks. In this lesson, we're going to answer two more questions pertaining to our rocket problem. Just to review the question or the setup, we have a rocket that's launched directly upward from an initial height of 25 feet. Its height, h of t in feet above the ground after t seconds, is given by the following equation. So let's answer some questions. First, I'd like you to determine the number of seconds it takes for the rocket to reach its maximum height and to find the maximum height of the rocket. So this is really two questions, actually. The first question is to determine the number of seconds it takes for the rocket to reach the max height. And then the second question is to find the maximum height. So I really want to know, how long does it take and how high does it go? So I'm going to give you a little hint. When we're talking about these vertical motion problems and you see the word maximum or minimum, typically we're talking about the vertex of a parabola, right? When we're dealing with quadratics, we're dealing with parabolas. So the vertex of the parabola will give you the maximum or minimum point on that parabola. The x-coordinate of this vertex will identify the axis of symmetry. If the parabola opens down, well, the vertex will give us the maximum value. So this point up here will give us the maximum value. And remember, this point's gonna have an x and y component to it. The x component's the axis of symmetry, and the y component, well, in our case here, it's gonna tell you how high the rocket is. And the x will actually tell you how long it took to reach that height. If the parabola were to open upward, well, the vertex would actually identify the minimum point. So let's tackle the first part of our two-part question. We're going to determine the number of seconds it takes for the rocket to reach its maximum height. Remember, if there was an x and y coordinate for the vertex, the x part would tell us the time it took to reach the y coordinate. So the axis of symmetry is given by x equals negative b over 2a when you have a quadratic in this form. F of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c. So if we take our original equation, we can kind of do some maneuvering to take our original equation and make it look like the quadratic in the standard form. And you'll notice instead of a, we have negative 16. So you could say a equals negative 16. Instead of b, we have 225. Our c is 25. And instead of x, we have t, but all in all, everything is pretty much the same. So we have x equals negative b over 2a. That will give us the axis of symmetry. So let's replace the letters with things that we know. We know b equals 225. So we put 225 in for b. We replace a with the negative 16. And when we do the math, we have negative 225 over negative 32. Which gives us about 7.031 seconds. It looks like I rounded to the nearest thousandth. And remember, in this example, our x actually equals t, right? We're replacing x with t. So this is really telling you that t equals 7.031 seconds. And that represents our axis of symmetry, which is also the x-coordinate or the t-coordinate of our vertex. Right, so graphically, if this is our parabola, the vertex is somewhere up here. We know that this value is 7.031 because we found the axis of symmetry, right? The axis of symmetry is that imaginary line that splits your parabola in half. So if this represents t and this is h of t, okay, well, we know what t is. It's 7.031, and we need to figure out what h of t will be. So again, back to our question, determine the number of seconds it takes for the rocket to reach its maximum height. Well, the answer is 7.031 seconds. That's how long it will take for the rocket to reach its maximum height. And we found that from the axis of symmetry. Now for the second part of our question, we want to know what that height is. We know how long it takes to get to the max height, but we want to figure out what is the maximum height. So we know part of the coordinates to the vertex. We need to find the second part to this vertex. So we're going to take the value that we found when finding the axis of symmetry and plug that into our original equation. So remember, the axis of symmetry was given by t equals 7.031 seconds. And we're going to replace t with 7.031 seconds. And then we're going to evaluate this equation. This is just simple algebra, and it cleans up to h of 7.031 equals, looks like 816.016 feet. So again, back to our original question, determine the number of seconds it takes for the rocket to reach its maximum height and find that maximum height. Well, the max height, it's right here, 816.016 feet. Many times on a test, I might actually just ask for the vertex as an ordered pair, and it would look something like this. Your axis of symmetry, you plug that into your original equation, and this gives us the height, or the y component of the ordered pair. And then again, just graphically, I want you to visualize what's going on here. Right, this was our axis of symmetry, this was our maximum height. This represents the time it takes to reach our maximum height.